Hello friends, welcome to Logic Tools. I'm Gaurav and in this video we are going to talk about C data types. Okay, but message for this video is capability is proportional to potential for programmers. Yeah, that's true. Actually, data types in C or any other programming language is a very important part. And so, in C language, data types are important because variables can't be defined without the data types. Okay, and data types makes the variable gives variable the potential to handle the data, the types of data, the floating type of data, different types of data. Okay, without a data type, a variable can't handle those data. So in C, we are going to start our program here. In C, we used to define variable with the help of a data type, with the help of a data type, right? So now let's make a new program, control, and let's save it as control F12 as potential.c, save it as. Now see, in this video we are going to talk about five types of data types. First one is int, then char, then float, then long, then double. Okay, so these are the data types we are going to discuss in this video. So at first we are going to use this data types and we are going to print the values of some of these data types. Okay, so now first of all include our libraries, include stdio.h and then hashtag include linear.h, fine. Now declare our main function and then open the function and simply return some zero fusion and get ch. Fine. So now we are ready to go with our data types. The first data types we have is our the int data type. Okay, we have our int data type here. So to declare an int data type, it is int means is a abbreviation for integer. So for declaring as integer data types, we are using int and then whatever the variable name is x is equal to some integer value. This can hold up to 10 bits long. Data, okay, depending upon the bit size, the memory allocation of this integer data type. Okay, so we use to print this, we would like to print this data using the printf command, printf, and inside that we write it as printf integer is what. Here we need to declare that we are using an integer variable here to include with the printf string. Okay, so for that we use %d and then our comma and then our variable name. Fine. Okay, let's test it out. Compilation is cool and then compile it. So our console gives that the integer is this as our written value. Fine. So this is how we declare and use the integer value. Now next is char. Now character is a bit different from the data integer data type because character holds the alphabetical numerical objects together in the form of an array. So to define a character, we used to define it inside an array. Okay, so that what C does, C breaks the whole length of string in a single bit and then turn it to the array and then send all the array into the variable. So let's say we define character as C and by this square brackets we used to define an array. We will talk it about it later on in this series. Okay, and then we can write here that this is a character. Okay, fine. So we defined a character data type. Now let's print it out and see what happens next. Is character is to define to give the character value to the printf command is we use %s and then here we use the variable name. Okay, control C is the variable name. Fine, let's test it out. Compilation is cool, the result is this. Okay, we are messing here with the two different lines, so to divide the lines, to break the lines after a message, we use \n. Okay, So we are going to use in every line backslash n so that we can separate line by line. So control F9. Okay, the console is already on. So control F9 now. Control F9, control F10, and this is all cool, right? So now let's get into the next float type. So right, float. Float is actually handling the integers, but a floating integer or a decimal point integer. Okay, so whenever you are using dividing type of operations and where decimal can occur, we are going to use this float data type. So we are using this float. Let's say it as x, y, okay, and let's give it some decimal integers like 22.11. Okay, and say to print this float, we use, let's say to print it, float is f and the variable is y. Okay, so now compile it. Compilation is right now. Run the program and we can see the float value is given in the data type. Okay, the float is important because if you give an integer value, integer float type data type, then it will only return the real value, real part of this integer. So control F9 is cool and see it returns the only the real part of the integer. Okay, so we don't use to give whenever we want decimal types of data, we use float, not the integer. Fine. Next is long. Now, long is a bit complicated because long can be used in two types. Long can be prefixed into other data types to increase the bit value, bit rate of the data, the memory allocation of the data. And long can be singly used to define integers type. Okay. So, for long, we use some integer like say we use y z. Okay, fine, and we give some integer value simply like this and enter it. Okay, to define to print long, we use c and control v. Okay, to print long, we use percentage ld with a print respected variable. And that's fine. Okay. Compilation is cool. Control F10 and C. Here we have a float data. Okay. Here we have a long data. So let's change it. Long. Control S. Control F9. Then Control F10. So here's the long. Fine. Cool. The last data that we are going to talk about is double. Now, double is something that we don't use, but we use it occasionally to handle octadecimal values. Like we can give 11, first we have to give a variable. So let's say d is a variable for double and it is equals to octadecimal value, that is 11 e plus 24. Okay, right. And to print this double, is double and this is e. Okay, fine. Now save it, compile it. Compilation is cool and F10. Now see, double value is the octadecimal represented here, but the actual value is represented like this. Okay, so this is how we use different data types in the C language. We used to declare it and we used to print it out. Okay, the scanning of this data is just similar as we discussed, like for scanning an integer, scanner. Okay, you need to give percent %d for the integer and then you need to write and x similar. Okay, all those symbols for different data types are same except the double. For double, we use not, we don't use here E, we use LF. Okay, so remember this, for the double, we use, for this double, we use LF to scan, percent %LF to scan. Okay, fine, I'm removing this for right now. And obviously, yes, this gives, this data type gives potential to the variables that character can handle, the arithmetic and the numeric and alphabetical values. The integer can handle the numeric values. Float can handle floating point. Double and long all can handle, these all can handle floating point values, but of different sizes. That is the most important difference between all these data types, that their sizes in the memory allocation is different. That's all for this video. Please subscribe the video, like our channel, and boom. Okay, fine. So let's get into the another video and define the give the differences between the variable and constant. Till then, bye bye, and thank you for watching this video.